In our final segment, we're going to look at something that really haven't talked too much about on this program, but I think all of us who are listening would probably know someone, family member or others, that would be in a nursing home. One of the consequences of the ongoing COVID-19 policies are the limitations, as we know, on nursing home visits and so forth, where our parents and grandparents might be living, or other family members. The preventing of family members from visiting has, on one hand, some substantive reasons when it comes to the spread of the virus, but on the other hand, unique to probably any other time in history, this separating of loved ones from the elderly, who are at a time in their life where they're, well, pretty much alone anyway. In fact, it may just be producing a scenario that in some degrees is more harmful than helpful. And I just looked at an article out of the United Kingdom from this very thing, talking about how lonely life has become for those in nursing homes, some not having any real physical contact with anybody for days on end. It was an amazing thing. So it's an issue that has gotten some other attention. And Twyla, I want to talk to you about that because it's a health freedom issue in a way, but you know, you have a concern. And you mentioned that to me when we have a duty biblically to honor our parents, to care for them when they are in need. And at that time of the life, they are. And we are thankful for really good nursing homes. There are many. There are some that are not, and that's why there are policies that govern them on state level. But many are very, very good. Yet you've identified a very practical and policy concern from a patient health freedom perspective that I don't think we want to miss. Tell us about your concern, would you?
I've just generally been concerned about the fact that these folks are seniors, are in these facilities. The facilities' doors have been locked. The seniors are the most vulnerable group to this condition. They know it. They're watching the news like the rest of us. They have no family that's allowed to be in there or to come to visit them. They're probably worried that they're going to die alone without their family, that even if they get it, they could go to the hospital, but then and they could be put on a vent, but at no time would they be able to see their family members. And I think this is just tragic. And I think that, you know, the one thing about freedom and in a free country is the ability to take risks and to take risks wisely. And when we think about protecting ourselves or protecting others and all these people walking around with masks and gloves and stuff, and just look at yourself when you're walking around with your mask and your gloves and figure out every place that your hands have gone. And unless you have washed your hands every time that they touch something, you are likely doing cross contamination. And so even if you've got a clean cart, the very second that you pick up a grocery item and you put it in your cart, who touched that grocery item before you? Did you wash your hands then before you touched your cart handle? No. Right. And so, you know, this is like impossible to really protect yourself against. Even isolation units in hospitals have a hard time making sure that the bug that's inside the room or the bugs that are outside the room don't, you know, get one way or the other. It's very, very difficult. And yet these people are being stranded, left alone, many of them to die alone without their families. You know, in Minnesota, we have a law that says that you can go into a quarantine area, but you might not be able to come out. Okay, fine. Take all your groceries with you and go stay with your loved one. You know, that's one way of doing it. But the other is just to recognize that it's impossible to control this illness. It just really is. And you can go in with all your stuff and, you know, see your family. I think it's just such a dishonorable thing, and it's such a, it's just not compassionate. It's not caring. It's not looking at the most important thing, which is the relationship.
So, Twyla, are you suggesting that those kinds of protective non-visit policies have just been overdone, are not necessary at all? Or what are you saying, just so our listeners are clear?
No, I think that you should do everything possible to, you know, to have clean hands. And you can choose not to, you know, get close to one another, but to actually go into the room and spend some time talking. If you want to be 6 feet away, fine. Or, you know, but just to allow that to happen, because a lot of seniors are probably dying of a lonely heart. They're not even allowed to congregate together for meals, right? So they're alone in the last days of their life. And if a family member wants to go in and see them, fine. Let there be a washing station, you know, let whatever happens there. If you want gloves. But it's really about protecting you more than anyone else with the gloves. So I would rethink that.
Okay. Gary, I want to go to you. We only have just a couple minutes left. Just give a minute comment. Early on in this process, I know you as a pastor were prohibited from going and visiting people who were sick and were dying, and that grieved your heart as a pastor. That kind of gets into the same space that Twyla's talking to us about.
And I still am. I can't get into the local nursing homes or the local hospitals, and I've had a few people in over these past weeks and months and just have to sit by and sort of watch. Even some of the family members can't get in. In fact, in our local hospital here in Altoona, Pennsylvania, they just opened it up the other day to the point that one support person can go in and visit a patient that's in there. And, you know, there's just something, and I know we don't have time to delve into it, but there's just something going through my mind, Twyla. Quickly, yes or no? God has created this body to have a certain amount of natural immunization built within it. Don't you think we just ought to let the body do what the body is designed to do under God's creation?
Right. There's some immunity that we are already given, all sorts of things like our skin and like cilia and all sorts of things in our nose, you know, and some people are going to die because they're susceptible or it's their time or, you know, whatever. God determines what time is. So no matter what, it's their time, right?
We're talking about these people in these homes and they're dying alone and they know it. You know, they really do know it. And from a pastoral perspective who works with people on a consistent basis, this is of great concern.